little interest in research. I think it must be about the brand of the radio that is a Lincoln. That anyway, in the history of USA, Lincoln is a pretty important name. So for sure, there is a meaning also in this. Okay, and here we arrive to Black Clouds and Silver Linings, that is a masterpiece of clues. And the first one is so evident that is really giving me goosebumps. You can see immediately on the left side the watching eye is there on a painting. A crow is arriving. There are four moons. That means that they are false. They can depict. Paint how many they want. It's just. This means that it's just a graphic. It's just something that is artificial. They can put how many fucking moon they want. And look at that kid. Opening there on the door, he is looking to reality through this door. Finally, the kid that is, I think, the metaphor for the people and some people that we can wake up. We are like kids opening a new door. Opening the door of the shell, the door of the Truman Show dome, you know, opening all these doors of knowledge, of conscience, of awareness. And look there. There is an elephant that is wisdom and longevity with a pencil, with a brush. He possibly painted the old watching eye, and that elephant possibly also wrote the books, those books. But these are the books of knowledge, evidently. I mean, the elephant is wisdom. The books are wisdom, are knowledge, and he is not allowing us to read them. And there is also a little mouse there, a white mouse, like a laboratory mouse. So the clues, and look once again, look at the logo of Dream Theater. I don't see any D and any T. I see a Masonic symbol. And this is really full of clues, really full. And there is also another version that is this one, Black Clouds and Silver Linings. And so just to have a look, they are telling us that through books we can reach the light, and they are already in the light, because the logo of Dream Theater, whatever it is in the light generated by the book. So there is a book, or I think in general books, ancient books, can give us the possibility to reach the truth, and realize that if these four moons are just a hoax. Okay, and this is a dramatic turn of events. The year is 2011, and this is the first album with Mike Mangini after Mike Pornoy left the band. I see, well, maybe some visionary clues in this artwork, but in a flat earth metaphor, this artwork can have real deep meanings. What I mean is that, let's take the guy on the monocycle on the string, like if it was the sun, and the rudder the tail of the aeroplane below, in fact, is just a few, very few space below the string. So this could be a metaphor to tell us that in fact the sun is much, much closer than we think, and that aeroplanes fly very close to him, and that if we go a bit too high, maybe we can even burn ourselves, like made Icarus, for example. I was thinking some days ago about the legend of Icarus. Icarus went too close to the sun, and the walks of his wings melt. And so this is mythology, but if it was it was true, and it was the tale of this guy really flying. Well, anyway, this is another thing. I digress. Look at also at the sheeple. There, you can find the sheeple aiming. There is someone aiming at the sheeple. This is the aim of a gun. And you are the sheeple. And they're telling us that you are the sheeple. We know it. And we are aiming at you. And we do whatever we want of you. Something like that. Or they do something. They do whatever they want of you. You are just a sheeple. You are not realizing that we are telling you that you are a sheeple. And you are under our aim. And that we know everything. And look at the well, this is another version, a good one, pretty bloody. I mean, of blood is very strong on the backs of the angels, the sheeple.
Turn on TV, bah, bah. Go to the church, bah, bah.
Well, dears, even if I'm not sure that this is an official one, this is one of my favorites, and well, Dream Theater, a dramatic turn of events, and well, this is an evident quotation of the Elohim flying, and the Bible is talking about the Elohim flying on their cherubs, and this could be exactly the Elohim flying on the cherubs, that in this case are metaphorized through stones. But a dramatic turn of events could be that someone is arriving. Well, not only the Bible is being spoken about flying objects. Also, vimanas in the Mahabharata and in other cultures, even in the Greek culture. And so. This is pretty interesting. To me, this means that they could know, they might know that some different beings capable of flying and possibly with superpowers will show, and it will be, in fact, a dramatic turn of events. And well, in fact, I could be waiting for something like that. I mean, yeah, could be. Well, could be the reason of a lifetime. And here, ta-ta! Dream Theater breaking the fourth wall. I mean, there is no more much need of interpretation here. This is an obvious allusion to the fakeness, the hoax, the falsity of whatever you can think about, and obviously. There in a special place you can see the Dream Theater logo, So they mean that possibly we are in the right time, and this fourth wall could be finally shown to us, the sheeple, even if I do not consider myself sheeple anymore. But anyway, I'm waiting. I don't know. Anyway, I don't know. I know that there is something wrong, but I don't know what it is. And maybe this is the moment when through the fourth wall we will know the truth. And in fact, the last artwork for the last cover, that is 2016, this same year, is really breathtaking. And here we go. This is the astonishing era 2000.